Hello friends, welcome to 5 Mantra. I am Ashok, faculty for reasoning. In our previous video, we have seen some basics of blood relation. This is a part of continuation for that topic. This is our next question. Probably this also has got extension. We'll see. I mean, every question in this particular type 2, it can be limited to one question or it can be extended for more questions also. So let us see initially this one. So what is asked? Which of the following is true? We have to identify one among them is to be true. For that we need to draw relationship tree. For that, in this puzzle type, what we need to do, initially we have to identify what is parent, where is this parent child relation among the given statements. Okay, so what is the observations we need to get from this? That is, in a family of 5 members, so a family of 5 members, there are parents and 3 children. So it has made this problem a bit simpler here. Parents and 3 children. So obviously parents will be out of 5. We can easily draw initially skeleton like this of this relationship tree. Parents will be one male and one female. So further, 3 children they have got. The members are A, B, C, D and E. So they are represented by A, B, C, D and E, out of which 2 are males and 3 are females. So it is also making this problem simpler further. 2 are males, 3 are females. So it is obvious that parents, out of parents, one male, one female will be there. So how many females further we need to get? 2 females. So total, out of total 3 females, mother is one female, obviously 2 daughters. Totally 3 females you have got. So obvious that for 2 males, one will be son, one will be father. So it is traced out now. Gender is also traced out by the beginning statements itself. Then try to understand the further statements. A has 3 children, of which 2 daughters. So it is giving you information that one of these 2 parents is A. So we cannot identify whether it is father or mother yet, isn't it? But A is a parent. So A has 3 children, of which 2 daughters and 1 son, which we already observed from the given statement earlier. Okay, so it is obvious here. Then C is B's son. C is B's son. So obviously A and B are parents, but we don't know the gender till this point. We don't know the gender of this A and B. A and B are parents. It is certain till this point. And who is C? C is son. So obviously we can place that son here, isn't it? Then A is D's father. So again another information is given. A is D's father. Obviously one in this family, one father is there, and that father mentioned as A. So this is, we can place A here. And obviously A is D's father, in the sense D is a child of A. Obviously we have filled the male child to be C. One among one between these 2 will be D. And it is also obvious that now A has become father, B will be mother. Who is left over here? E. So this is the relationship tree we can draw from this given statements. From these given statements we can trace out this relationship tree, which will give you this answers for this statement. What is asked here? Which of the following is true? So try to observe which among these options will be true according to this tree. Okay, so first one, try to observe. B is D's mother. Is it true? So it is solved here itself. At the very first option it is solved. So just for practice, try to see the other options also. Just for practice, try to check. E is D's mother. Is it so? No, this is not correct. Then C is D's mother. C is D's mother. No, they are siblings actually. Then A is D's mother. A is D's mother. The A is a parent, but he is a male. A is father, not mother. So, which is again obvious from this statement. So, our answer is, which we already found anyway. Then, let's see. An extension for this question is also given. Try to observe this. So, for the same relationship tree we have drawn for the beginning question. So, we can use that and we can find the option for this particular statement. So, what is asked here? How is E related to B? So, identify where is E. E is related to B. How is E related to B? E is nothing but daughter of B. Being a female here, E. So, she will be daughter of B. Isn't it? So, what is the answer here? B will be the E. I mean, E will be the daughter of B. And you must be careful because sometimes when you are in hurry, these kind of questions you should not, as we have mentioned earlier, you should not answer them in hurry. Okay, you should answer it at a peace of mind because you may go wrong. So, the other option is also given here, which is ready, mother. So, which may make you step into trap because, so we are identifying the B and E relationship. So, in a hurry, if you could answer like, so B is mother of E. So, you may answer to be mother also. So, please be careful while answering these questions. Okay. So, obviously, E is related to B as daughter, isn't it? E is the daughter of B in simpler way. Okay. Let us move ahead. This is our next problem. We know how these examples are. So, it is a bit tricky here. So, try to observe this carefully. Let us read out these statements. And one point you need to remember always is this second type. We need to identify parent-child relation first. So, identify where it is. First, read out. So, every problem which is given, first read out, which you obviously do. From that, you will have in your mind, so what all given. Then identify what is parent-child relation, which is located here, where it is located. So, try to read. There are 6 persons A, B, C, D and F. Means 6 persons represented by A to F. C is the sister, brother, husband. D is the father. Okay. So, this is what we are looking for here now. This is what we are looking for, parent-child relation. So, first start the problem with that. There are 2 fathers, 3 brothers and a mother in the group. Okay. So, first identify that relation. Then, D is the father of, I can draw like this, D is the father of A and A's gender is not certain from this. So, D is father, so obviously male. D is the father of A. And grandfather of F. D is the father of A and grandfather of F. So, where could be F? F could be the child of A. F could be the child of A. So, let us bring it here. F is the child of A and grandfather of F. Obvious that F, grandfather is D and A's father is D. Okay. So, from this statement underlined, is covered here. Next. So, now we will move ahead with other statements given. So, try to check. So, what is given here? C is the sister of F and B is the brother of E's husband. Okay. In order to trace it out, we need to look for another statement which is also given here, which is very important. There are two fathers in the means whole family. So, two fathers we have got already. In this very first part of the tree we drawn, two fathers we identified. So, who are they? D and A. This part is covered. Next, try to see three brothers and a mother. So where is this mother actually? I assume that you might have read this statement whole. So if you see in this, where is mother? Where is another female here? B is the brother of his husband. So you can easily identify that E is a mother here. So E has got husband, isn't it? So E has got husband. So obviously E could be a mother. So the problem is here. So where to place this mother? Who is E? Who is E? So we are discussing about this. We need to start with parent-child relation, and the immediate generation we need to go ahead with this problem, this kind of problems. And it can be assumed here. See here, it can be assumed E could be the wife of E's husband, could be A, or E's husband could be D. Anything is possible when you see this for first time, isn't it? But order you need to always follow is from parent-child relation, then we have to go ahead with another generation. So here child is F, so obviously the mother, if you are speaking of one mother, if you are speaking of, that mother should be placed to the immediate generation of this, the bottom one, isn't it? F's above generation, you need to place that mother. So obvious that E should be placed above F. And one more statement given here is B is the brother of E's husband. So E's husband, who is E's husband now? So E is now, E's husband is given, so E is obviously female. E is female. E's husband is A. It is obvious from these statements. So obvious that E's husband is A. A is male. Then what is given? B is the brother of E's husband. So who will be B? Brother of E's husband. Here lies B. So brother is given, obviously he will be male, isn't it? Then further, have we done it, done with it? No, not yet. So how many members you have? 6 persons, only 5 are covered here. One more person we need to place here. So where is it? C is the sister of F. So F is here, and where you can place that C? Here. Who is sister? So obviously a female. And try to identify the gender of F. So what is given here? How to identify the gender of F now? So important statement, the final statement, that is there are 2 fathers, 3 brothers and a mother in the group. So how many fathers we have already covered? D and A. One mother is also covered. She is the mother of F and C. So E is the mother of F and C. Then one more part we need to cover is 3 brothers to be covered here. Since 2 fathers, mother is covered, 3 brothers. Identify 3 brothers here. Where are they? So A and B could be together called as brothers 1 and 2. These 2 are a set of brothers. One more brother from this relationship tree we have to identify. So obviously F gender is not certain now. So from this particular information, 3 brothers, it will be certain now that F's gender is male. So who is the brother of C? So obviously how many brothers you have got now? A, B, F, they are 3, isn't it? So in this relationship chart you have drawn now. So you need to be careful with, as I always say, you need to be careful with drawing this relationship. So once you draw and you are certain, you are sure with that, so obviously you can trace out whatever the questions will be asked. Now, so go ahead with the, we'll go ahead with this first question. Who is the mother of, who is the mother? So it is obvious while drawing it, this itself, we have identified E to be mother. So the answer is E. Let us see, what are the questions given ahead. See, one more question is given. Using the same relationship tree, we have to answer this one. This is the first part we have seen. Now, this is the extension of that question. The same tree will be useful, obvious. Let us see. What is the question given? Who is husband? Is husband, isn't it? Once we draw this relationship tree, so obviously, whatever the number of questions given, we can easily trace out. But, so it is clear that we need to be careful while drawing this relationship tree. Once it is drawn, everything is simple. Identify who is his husband, obviously. A. So, our answer is A, that is the option C. Okay, don't get confused. Next, we will see next part of the question. So, next part is, how is F related to E? Let's see again this tree. How is F related to E? So, where is E this? So, how these two are related? F is related to E. So, F is nothing but obviously mother. I mean, E is mother of F. So, F is son of E. So, how is the relation? Since F is a male here, obviously F is son of E, isn't it? Let us check other part of the question. Check here. What is asked? Which of the following is a group of brothers? See, according to the problem statement, we have seen there are three brothers. So, we have identified there itself also while drawing this relationship tree. So, who are they? Brothers. Set of brothers A and B. And another brother is the brother of C. So, F is also one brother. A and B are brothers, isn't it? So, 1, 2, 3. These three are set of brothers. Although they are not the brothers mutually, but these three are set of brothers. What are they? A, B and F. So, which option? Option A is correct. A, B and F. Okay, let us move ahead. After that previous problem, which we have seen various parts of that, then our next problem is based on profession. You could see here in this question, you can see some questions based on the relations along with the professions, blood relation along with professions, we could see in some examinations. Okay, if at all you get such questions, how to solve them? This is the last model in this particular discussion for type 2. We'll see. So, what is the statement given here? So, there are A, B, C, D, E, F and G. So, how many members? Basically, 7 members. 7 members are family members, members of a family consisting of 4 adults and 3 children. Two of whom in the sense? 2 of these 3 children are F and G are girls, isn't it? A and D are brothers. So, let us not make it complex here. So, let first read out the statement as you always have to do whatever the problem is given. First, you need to read out the whole thing. So, let us do that. Family consisting of 4 adults and 3 children, 2 of whom F and G are girls, A and D are brothers. A and D are brothers and A is a doctor. E is an engineer married to one of the brothers. Married to one of the brothers and has 2 children. And has 2 children. Then B is married to D. G is their child. So, try to observe here. So, with which relation we have to start always? As I already told you, type 2 should be always started with parent-child relation. Parent-child relation, that relation will help you to trace out the remaining things. So, identify where exactly you need to start. See here. F and G, brothers, it could be, you can take this one. Start with this. G is their child. Whose child? B is married to D. Whose child is G. So, let us start with this part. this last statement. Okay, so how to draw that? G is their child. I'll draw this G here. G is the child of B, who is married to D. So obviously B and D are a couple together. G is their child. Then go ahead with the other parts. Okay, so what is given? And this is also very important information here. This is also very important information. How many? 4 adults and 3 children are there. 4 adults and 3 children. So obviously one child we have found. The other 2 children we need to locate. So let me put this side. Other 2 children, let me place here. Because total 3 children must be there, 4 adults are there. Okay. So one child we have found, 2 children we are placing, and we don't know them yet. Okay. And we don't know the gender of the G also yet. Okay. Let us move to other statements again. So let us come back to the first statement. What is given? Two of whom, 3 children, 2 of whom F and G. Okay. Already we found G, and one more child is F according to this statement. F and G are girls. So gender is also given. These 2 are girls, isn't it? F and G, the two of whom, 3 children, 2 of whom F and G are girls. So we have identified the gender of these 2 children also. Isn't it? Next, we'll move ahead. A and D are brothers, and A is a doctor, and we don't know, one is empty here, we cannot identify where exactly A is. Okay, where to locate? So among these, it is clear that A and D are brothers, D is already located, so obviously A can be placed here. Isn't it? These 2 are A and D are brothers. In the sense, brothers both are males. So, A and D are males here. So, obvious that once D is male, B will become female here. Isn't it? It is obvious from this statement. Then, who is A? A is a doctor. Let us put a code here for doctor here. Then E is an engineer and married to one of the brothers. Okay, so one of the brothers. How many brothers you have got? A and D are the brothers here. Okay, so we cannot put another person here, because 3 are children, they cannot get married. Obviously that E has to be placed above here, which will become E will become another adult here. And since D is already married to B, so E will be married to obviously A, isn't it? It is obvious that E is an engineer married to one of the brothers. So brothers are A and D. So one of the brothers is married to B. So obviously E is married to A. So which letter is left over now? Which person is left over out of this? A to G, B we have found, C is left over here. So obviously here 3 children we got and 4 adults we got according to the given information, isn't it? So this is the first information. It is satisfying here, 4 adults and 3 children. Okay. So further, is there any other information in this such that we can trace out trace out the gender of C? Because in this relationship tree, it is not found that complete here. Okay. So let us see one more statement. I think we left over one statement. And has 2 children. So this is also one important point here. We missed out. Has 2 children. Who has 2 children? E is an engineer married to one of the brothers. So obviously, E married to A has 2 children. They could be these 2. Isn't it? It is obvious here. Okay. Then, So what else you have in this? And we have forgot to inform here that he is, look at, he is engineer. Okay, so we have placed the professions also. Let us see. So what, isn't this the relationship tree here? So is the gender is not sure, see. So can you make any thing out of this? Three children, A and D are brothers. Married to one of the brothers, has two children. B is married to G and G is their child. G is their child. F and G are girls. So obvious that out of which this statement again, you need to be careful while reading these statements. So because this gender is not sure, I am just reiterating, I mean reading this particular statement because in order to trace out the gender of C. Okay. So that can be again found through this very statement that three children, two of whom F and G are girls. What do you mean by that? Two of whom are girls implies another one which we found from this relationship tree, that is C is boy, isn't it? So two of them F and G are children, I mean out of these three children, two of them are girls. Obviously, if it is given they are girls, obviously the third one will be a boy. So gender is also evident from this. Okay. So this is the relationship tree we can draw from whatever the data, whatever the statements they have provided, isn't it? So first question. So now we have drawn the relationship tree. So what is the question asked here? What is the question asked? Who is C? Who is C? Directly from this we can make out anything. C could be the son of E. C could be the nephew of D. Isn't it? So anything we can make out. But check the appropriate option here. So what is given here? First one, A's son. Just check out whether it is correct or not. A's son. So here itself it is solved. C is nothing but A's son. So it is solved here itself. So our option is, our answer is A's son. Okay. So let's see, just for practice. So let's see the other options also, whether you find them appropriate or not. E's daughter. Whether this C is E's daughter or not from this chart. Where is C here? Where is E? Although E is mother of C, but C is not daughter because C is a male, a boy, isn't it? So this is not correct. Then F's father. So C is F's father. No way. C is a child. He cannot become, I mean, he cannot be considered as father. So this is also ruled out. Then G's brother. So you cannot directly mention them as brother, but C is, G is nothing but cousin. C is not G's brother. C is G's cousin. So likewise, if you check all the other options also, you can identify other relations also. So it will be a better practice also. But first of all, try to observe the answer, then try to check the other options. So what could be the relation and what could be the names you can give there, isn't it, for those other options. So another problem before getting into this, let us see this previous problem again. See here, if you identify something here, engineer and doctor, the professions which is the data which is nowhere useful in this, isn't it, the information which is nowhere useful in this particular problem. Maybe the more number of words, such words may initially intimidate you, like it seems to be complex initially. So but once you draw this relationship tree, so it will be easy always. Relationship tree is the crucial part in every problem, isn't it? So anyway, doctor and engineer, whatever the information about the professions given is a redundant information here. But don't worry. So we'll see the next problem which makes count of this profession also. Okay, so how to solve that problem? We'll go ahead. Thank you. See here. So this is the model which includes both blood relations along with professions. So it seems complex, but always as with peace of mind, never solve such questions in a hurry. Okay, peace of mind. If you take out the logic properly, once you construct this relationship tree, you can easily answer it appropriately. Okay. So let us read out the question first. There are two married couples in the family D. The engineer is married to the lady teacher. The professor is married to the doctor. F, the manager is the son of B and brother of E. C, the doctor is C, the doctor is the daughter-in-law of A. E is the unmarried lawyer. A is the grandfather of F. Who is the what is the profession of B? See here. Obvious that from what is the difference between previous problem and this problem? There, the professions was whatever the profession mentioned is just redundant data which was not useful in that problem. Here we need to identify the profession. Okay, so it is obvious that it seems complex, but we'll try to make it simple. Okay, so try to observe here. As I already told you, second type can be solved. First, identify the parent-child relation. Okay, so try to check out the parent-child relation here. Where is it? Out of this whole thing, C, the doctor is the daughter-in-law of A, grandmother, and E is the unmarried lawyer. Professor is married to doctor, married to lady. Here you have F, the manager is the son of B and brother of E. So first thing you need to consider is parent-child relation. We will start with that. Okay. So what is that? F, the manager is the son of B, isn't it? So we will place that first. F, who is F? The son of B, obviously, implies that F is a male, isn't it? Son of B. And brother of E. F is brother of E. So we can place that E also here itself. So this statement is finished now. And who is F? F is the manager. Let me put a code for manager. Okay, so this is F is manager, isn't it? Then go ahead with the other statements. Let us go with the initial statement. What are the statements? There are two married couples in the family. So this is also very important. Two married couples are available. This point is also very important here. Then the engineer D, the engineer is married to the lady teacher. D, the engineer is married to lady teacher. So nowhere you can see, and we don't know where to put exactly this D. Okay. See here, this children parent is available. The other generation could be grandparents of this F, isn't it? So it is obvious that we can easily understand that these can be put, that D, the engineer, is married to lady teacher. We can put the generation above this. Why? Because two married couples are available in the sense, one married couple are parents, one married couple will be grandparents of this F, isn't it? It is clear from this. So I can put somewhere here. See here. So I can put somewhere here this who is the doctor? D, the engineer. So D, who is the engineer? D, the engineer, he is married to lady teacher. So obviously D is a male. He is married to a lady teacher. And we don't know that notation actually. So whether it is E, whatever, A or whatever, we don't know yet. So obviously she is a female, and because a lady teacher is provided the information, isn't it? So how you set these things? Based on the thing, first thing you identified is parent-child relation. Then we could, based on this relation, we could place this D appropriately here. Why? Because this point is also, another point is also supporting here. There are two married couples in the family. So obviously, one married couple will be the parents, the other married couple will be the grandparents. So we have identified, we have located this D here. Obviously, D and some other person will be the grandparents. Okay, of F and E. Okay, so let us see. Let us complete this tree with the remaining information. So what is the other information? The professor is married to the doctor. Where exactly the doctor is here? We don't know exactly the doctor, but is married. One more married couple. Already we have done with, we made this relation here in the tree. Then we have professor married to doctor. Obviously, one of these generation is a doctor. I mean, doctor married to professor. Okay, so professor, where you can put? And we don't know. We don't know who is, whether B is professor or this particular person, that is, the professor is married to doctor. Just we know the professions here. And who is doctor? Doctor or professor, this could be. Who is doctor and who is professor? We don't know. Isn't it? Do we know from this statement? We are not sure from this statement. So let us put it like this. Okay. So further, what is given? F, the manager, which we have done already. C, the doctor is the C, the doctor. C, the doctor. We can easily place C. Once B is given, so obviously C is the doctor. So C is doctor, not professor. Obviously, B is professor. B is professor here. So C is the doctor. C, the doctor, is the daughter-in-law of A. Is the daughter-in-law of A. So obviously C, the doctor, is the daughter-in-law. Obviously C is female. B is a male, a daughter-in-law of A. Daughter-in-law of A means we have to look into the generation above this level. Okay, so D is already occupied here. So A we need to, only position we can keep here is A, and C is the daughter-in-law of A. So how you connect this generation to this generation? Since C is daughter-in-law, we can connect like this. Isn't it? So B is nothing but the son of D. B is nothing but the son of D. Then only C will be the daughter-in-law of A. Okay. So let us check whether we have finished all the statements or not. So this is done. Then E is the unmarried lawyer. A is the grandmother of F. So here one more statement. A is the grandmother of F. So from this relationship tree, can you identify or not? A is the grandmother of F. So it is obvious once we draw, before even reaching the statement also, we could identify that relation, that A is grandmother of F, isn't it? This is also done. Yeah, we are identifying some statements here. Now coming to E. E is the unmarried lawyer. We already identified E here in the relationship tree, but we are identifying the profession now. Who is E? E is a lawyer. Let me put like this, LR, a lawyer. So try to check all the relations and professions also together kept or not, isn't it? So here D is engineer, A is lady teacher, C is doctor, B is professor, F is manager, E is lawyer. Every relation is set and every profession is set in this relationship tree. Okay, so whole thing, whatever described in the problem statement example, is located in this relationship tree. Okay, now we'll try to solve what is the actual question asked. Okay, so what is asked here? What is the profession of B? What is the profession of B? And while discussing, while constructing this relationship tree itself, we have identified what is the relation of B. What is that? Professor. Isn't it? Our answer is professor, the option B. Isn't it? So, like that, from this relationship tree, from this question again, it is limited to only one question, this one. We can extend this even means if in examinations, they may extend such questions to more marks. I mean, more number of questions related on the same data. So, obviously, if you go wrong with this relationship tree, you may go wrong with all the questions related to this particular statements, isn't it? So, please be careful while solving this kind of problems, because as we discussed earlier, first type of problems will be mostly asked for one mark, and there is a chance that second and third kind of problems, that is puzzle and coded problems, will be asked for even for one mark or more than even for 3 or goes up to 5 marks also, based on the complexity and based on the number of related questions. I mean, related questions based on same data, same statements, isn't it? So you need to be careful with this relationship tree. So what are the points we discussed in this type 2? First thing is, we need to go ahead with first we need to read out the whole problem, then we need to identify parent-child relation. We have to start drawing this relationship tree with parent-child relation, then go ahead with the other statements. Okay, so that will make this problem, analyzing this puzzle, simpler. Okay, I hope you got enough information, I mean enough experience to solve similar kind of problems. So I hope this will be a good practice for you. So keep watching the other parts of this topic, that is blood relation. So we will be discussing the other type and also the previous questions of all the types together. We will make a video related to that also. So please subscribe to watch all the videos. Thank you.